Wednesday night before the conference started, I shared a message on praying for the missionaries, and I had to start it by saying, "Who failed? Who failed in this?" And God helping us, we want to help lead our church in praying more. And there's some things we can do, but you need to start first in a conviction in your heart. You know, I think about what you shared with the family, the Westco family, that the missionary just got to the field just a couple of weeks, and they went into town during the election, and he was shot in the head. And I just wondered, as I thought about that, I know God is sovereign, and God is powerful, and God, but I just wonder if that had been one of our missionaries, could we have said, "We're praying for them"? Yes. And I said, I started Wednesday by saying to our little group that was here on prayer meeting that, you know, I failed in this. I do pray. Sometimes I pray for missionaries, like I'll pray like this. I'll say, knowing about the unreasonable and wicked men, and annoying stories of Satan that directs his evil men. I would say, "Father, when a missionary is walking down the street, he's about to cross the street, and there's an enemy, a wicked man," and I said, "when he turns this way, let that missionary walk across the street. So that when he turns his head, he doesn't see him." That's how specific we need to be, knowing how our Father can direct the affairs of men. Some things we only get by prayer and fasting. Some things we have not because we ask not. And if that had been one of our missionaries that had been shot, and we're thinking of his passing and his family, and then the Holy Spirit says, "Were you praying for him today?" If that had been our missionary, if we're not as diligent as the message shared that we should be in that, we might have said, "But you know, I had to go to the store. And you know, my car was broke down. And you know, I had a flat. And you know, the kids were sick. And you know, I just wasn't feeling well. And you know, I've got this trouble in my own life. And you know, we didn't pray." So let's stand and let's bow our heads. And the songwriter's going to come with an invitation song in a moment. And I pray that we would search our heart. We have visitors here. We have other pastors here. We have friends here. We have our folks here. And I just want to say, as your pastor, I want to do better in keeping our missionaries before us. I want to make it, put them in your hands better. But it's going to be you that God will speak to your heart and say, "I'm sorry, Lord. I've been covered about with many things, and I just haven't prayed." And one day we're going to stand before God, yes, about our giving and our abundance, sacrificial giving to missionaries, but also our time, that we could pray and call out their name and said, "Protect them from the snakes. Protect them from the drunk drivers. Protect them on those terrible roads. They don't have roads like we do. Their best roads looks like our peak road. And they're going to fix it one day, but they won't fix those roads. And Lord, help us and forgive us. Help us to pray, Lord. Speak to hearts. If there's anyone here that's never submitted themselves to the righteousness of God, in being a sinner and a lost soul, separated, self-willed, self-centered, self-focused, self-demanding, and never said, I die to that and give you my life. You tell me what to do. You tell me how to fix it. You tell me what to say and pray. You tell me, because you're my Savior. Lord, I pray you might save someone that's not saved. You know that I don't. But Lord, I do know that as Christians, we get busy. And we have to say we're sorry. So Lord, speak to our hearts in conviction and brokenness about prayer. Lord, before we have to hear that one of our missionaries died and we say, I didn't pray that day, I didn't pray that week, I didn't pray that well. So Lord, prick our hearts, make this real to us.